This episode is brought to you by Skillshare. I had my Tesla Powerwall installed near the end of 2020, and it's been working really well so far. The Tesla gateway has been managing when and where my solar panel energy is directed and will keep me up and running during a blackout. It's been great, but there's a major gap in how all home batteries function, and this smart home electric panel fixed that gap in the user experience. Let's take a closer look at my Powerwall and the Span smart panel, and if you should get one. I'm Matt Ferrell. Welcome to Undecided. To put this up front, Span did provide their panel for me to use and review, but as always, my opinions are my own. No holds barred, and they're seeing this video right along with you for the very first time. Well, unless you're a patron, in which you got to see this video a little bit early. But anyway, before I get into what exactly this thing does and what I think about it, it's important to look more closely at how my Tesla Powerwall is set up and why I did what I did. All home battery systems work in the same way. They act as a middleman between the grid and everything in your home. So that means they're controlling if your excess solar panel production is getting funneled into the battery system or to the grid. In the case of a blackout, the battery system will disconnect your house from the grid for safety, because you don't want uncontrolled electricity going back into the power grid if workers are working on the power lines. So during a blackout, the battery system makes your house a microgrid, managing solar power generation and electricity use from the battery. Now, I have a video that goes into more detail on home batteries, which I'll include a link in the description. But there's a wrinkle. Battery systems like the Powerwall have limitations in how much power they can accept at once while charging, and how much they can give out while discharging. The best analogy is to picture a water hose. A large diameter hose means more water can flow, and the same is true for batteries. For instance, the EcoSonin battery can accept and output about 5 kilowatts of power. The Tesla Powerwall can handle about 5 kilowatts during load and 7 kilowatts at peak, but Tesla is actually increasing that amount through a software update. And it's that power rating that limits how much you can run at once in your house during a blackout, as well as how much solar power generation the battery can accept at once. Too much power generated from solar and the system will turn off your solar array. Too much power draw from your appliances and the whole system will shut down. This means when you're getting something like a Powerwall installed, you have to decide if you want to get multiple batteries to cover all of your power needs, or if you need a sub-panel or critical loads panel for essential load with fewer batteries. Basically, you hardwire certain circuits to remain on in case of a blackout. Any circuits that aren't in that critical loads panel will lose power in a blackout to ensure that you stay within your battery's power capacity. Typically, you'd put things like your HVAC system, refrigerator, things along those lines, into the essential loads panel. But once it's installed, that's how it is unless you get an electrician to come by and make any changes. For my system, I was getting one Powerwall installed and opted to not have a critical loads panel at all. That means during a blackout, my wife and I would have to remain diligent in controlling our electricity usage. So during a blackout, that might mean turning off the AC, making sure that we turn off computers and appliances that we don't need. It's not super convenient, but it was cheaper than hardwiring a critical loads panel when we had the Powerwall installed. But that's where this little beauty comes in. The Span smart panel brings in a nice dose of smart home goodness into the mix. And if you've been watching my channel for a while, you know that I love my smart home gadgets. This panel works just like a traditional electric panel. In fact, it can use traditional circuit breakers, so there's no special hardware or hoops for the electrician to figure out. And since it's familiar parts, any electrician should feel right at home installing one of these. Now, the unit I have here is their new second generation panel, which is smaller than their previous generation. They shaved off a few inches in depth and height, so the footprint is closer to a traditional panel. The overall panel can handle 200 amps, and each circuit is capable of supporting 90 amp breakers versus the previous 70 amps. It's really enough to handle your average home, including EV charging, like my Tesla wall connector. And currently the Span can work in conjunction with the Tesla Powerwall and SolarEdge LG Chem batteries, but they are working on adding more. In my specific case, we're talking about the Tesla Powerwall. And I had a pretty bad experience with the Powerwall installation, which had nothing to do with Tesla. My third-party electrician did not do a great job. They ran communication wires on the outside of the conduit, which went against Tesla's own installer guidelines. I won't rehash everything. You can watch my video on that experience if you want to learn from my mistakes. The link for that is also in the description. On the opposite end of the spectrum, I have to give a big shout out to Brian Sadler and Revolusun, who did the Span installation. Dave King was the master electrician and Cole Ashman from Span. A big thumbs up for the installation experience with all of them. Now, what makes the Span special though is literally behind the scenes. Behind the traditional breakers are computer controlled breakers, which can monitor energy usage and be controlled through the app. If you manually flick a switch, the breaker is off and no software will turn it back on. But the computer-controlled secondary breaker gives you some incredible control and insights into where your electricity is going, when, and how much. And remember how I don't have a critical loads panel, which means having to jump into action during a blackout to make sure I don't push the system to the breaking point? Well, SPAN lets you add circuits to a virtual critical loads panel. Actually, three prioritized virtual panels. You have your must-have group, a nice-to-have group, and a not-essential group. With a couple of taps, you can move circuits in between those groups whenever you like. Right now, I've got things like my refrigerator and furnace in the must-haves, but my AC, dishwasher, and stove are in the nice-to-haves. If the Powerwall hits 50% or lower, anything in the nice-to-have group gets switched off during a blackout. The non-essential group gets shut off immediately in a blackout condition. Even cooler is that since SPAN knows how much each circuit is currently using, it can give you an estimate for how long your battery will last during a blackout and its current charge versus a full charge. The app shows you estimates for how much extra battery time you'll get if you move one circuit from one group to another, all based on your data. This is a killer feature that really fixed the downside of my setup. Any home battery setup, really. It means you get more out of fewer home batteries. And beyond that, it has some similarities to aftermarket energy monitors that you can add to an electric panel. I've got a couple of videos about the Sense Energy Monitor and an interview with their CEO if you'd like to see more on that. But the similarities between something like Sense and SPAN are fairly superficial. Sense is more of a passive device, giving you mainly information. SPAN does that too, but the smarts around controls, which are very granular controls, really put it into a completely different class of system. On the energy monitoring side of things, it actually helped me zero in on some energy usage I had trouble tracking down, even with Sense. Since it's tracking usage per circuit, I learned about some overly ambitious dehumidifier use in our basement room, as well as the fact that my server and networking setup has been drawing more power than I originally thought. I've been trying to make adjustments to bring that down, but I can't get rid of that stuff. It's the life of being a YouTuber and needing an insane amount of storage space. Now, SPAN has a brand new app to go along with their updated panel, and it's pretty slick. You can actually go download the app and try it with a simulated home to get a sense for what it can do. I'd recommend checking it out. The dashboard gives you a really nice overview of where the power is coming and going. There's some similarities between the Tesla app and the Powerwall display, which I think is actually a very good thing. The visual does a great job conveying a lot of information. But a simple scroll below your home and you'll see which circuits are using the most electricity at that moment, and a projection for how much backup time you have in your battery. One screen that surprised me how much I liked it was the circuit screen. You can group circuits by room, which I had no idea how much I wanted and kind of needed something like that. The labeling on your electric panel can be cryptic at best, and some circuits span rooms. And since you could add circuits to multiple rooms, it creates a very intuitive view to quickly track down which circuit you need to turn off if you have to do some work. No more trudging down to the panel to switch off a circuit, to walk back up to the room where you were, just to discover it was the wrong circuit. Within a few seconds, you can confirm which circuit it is and get to work. Now, it's definitely not recommended to use just the software switch before doing electrical work. After confirming the circuit, you really should go to the panel and use the manual switch. And finally, the SPAN app has a feed of insights based on your usage and data, like highlighting circuits that had high energy usage from the previous week, or how much solar you generated and how much of your use it covered. It even calls out specific circuits that were 100% solar powered, like my dishwasher just a few weeks ago. It's these kinds of notifications and insights that can help you understand how to shift your electricity usage to maximize your solar power and costs, especially if you live in an area with time of use rates. So is the SPAN panel worth it? Before I get to that, I'd like to thank Skillshare for sponsoring this video. They've built an incredible online learning community with thousands of classes for creators, and when it comes down to it, we're all creators. They've got classes for everything from writing to graphic design, to web development, to entrepreneurship and leadership. Now, I've been on a major productivity kick, working smarter, not harder, and they've got some amazing productivity classes as well. I've got another recommendation from Thomas Frank. I'm really loving his videos on Skillshare. His Productivity Masterclass created a custom system that works. It's all about getting ideas out of your head and into a system that you trust. I've always struggled with tossing things into a digital wasteland, never to be seen from again. This has been helping me with that. Now, everything on Skillshare is curated for learning, so there are no ads and they're always launching new premium classes. There's really something for everyone on Skillshare to continue learning and growing. There's nothing better than being able to do something today that you couldn't do yesterday. The first 1,000 people to use this link will get a 1-month free trial of Skillshare. Thanks to Skillshare and to all of you for supporting the channel. So back to if the SPAN smart panel is worth it. Given its cost, which is about $3,500, the span panel is not for everyone. That's really the biggest con of the system. And if you don't have solar panels or a battery, and you're not planning on upgrading your home's electricity capacity, then the answer is no, this is not for you. The cost benefit doesn't work out in that case with parts and labor. However, if you're getting solar panels and a battery system, you're going to be doing a lot of electrical and panel work anyway, so I think the answer is a big yes if you combine it with that install. When I was getting quotes for my Tesla Powerwall install, some of which included installing a critical loads panel, the extra costs of that critical loads panel were more than the span smart panel costs. In that use case, it's kind of a no-brainer to go with the flexibility and added smarts of span versus hardwiring a solution that requires an electrician and extra money to change down the road, and it can't help you streamline your energy use. It's a pretty simple equation there, especially when you consider that span can also help you get more use out of fewer batteries. The real-time controls and smarts around battery management means you can install one or two batteries instead of three or four. Now consider that batteries like this typically run between $7,000 and $10,000 each. That can help reduce the overall cost of your battery installation for your home. Span really does fill that circuit level control that's missing from home battery systems. Now, while you should only buy a product for what it can do for you today, I'm pretty excited about the potential of the Span system. They did tell me about a few software updates in the works that sound pretty cool, like an early warning system so that if it detects anomalies, they'll let you know. It's a really nice safety add-on. Another feature that they're adding is being able to schedule circuits. So if you have circuits that are just light fixtures, you can get scheduled smart controls out of the box. It's also great for time of use rates, since you can better control and shift when you're using specific circuits and at what time. And that's just a couple of the coming updates. And speaking of smart homes, right now the system integrates with Amazon Alexa, but I'm hopeful it'll open up more widely to other systems so I can start hooking this into the rest of my smart home setup. For me, that's when this thing really will start to sing. They didn't tell me anything specific on that point, but there's so much potential there. In case you couldn't tell, I really love this thing and can't wait to see where it goes. But what do you think? Do you have any interest in something like Span combined with a battery system like a Tesla Powerwall? Jump in the comments and let me know. If you're interested in getting solar and batteries installed and live in the US, I'd recommend checking out my Energysage portal. It's a great free resource to do research and find some great installers in your area. It's an affiliated program that I am a part of, but I really do love their service. It's how I found my solar installer. If you like this video, be sure to check out one of the ones I've linked to right here. Be sure to subscribe and hit that notification bell if you think I've earned it. And as always, a big thank you to all my patrons. Your support is really making these videos possible. But even if you aren't a patron, you're still doing something absolutely awesome just by watching and commenting. Thanks so much. I'll see you in the next one.